Microsoft has released security updates that will prevent attackers from exploiting the recently disclosed Microsoft Exchange vulnerabilities. This is the most effective way to stop attackers from accessing your servers. After installing the update, you will still need to determine if your server has already been exploited and accessed by an attacker, which will be covered in another video. The security update will prevent future exploitation, but will not stop an attacker that already has access. A link to each web page used in the video will be provided in the description. First, you'll need to determine the version of Exchange server you are running. From the server, click on the Start menu and start typing Exchange. When you see the Exchange Management shell, click on it. After the shell loads, type in git exchange server vertical bar format list name edition admin display version. This will show you which version number and software build you're running. On this server, we're running version 15.2 build 792.3. Write down your server version information since we'll need to use it as a reference to see which version of Exchange and cumulative update is installed. This will help you find the right security update to install. Next, open a web browser and go to the page that lists the Exchange server versions. Scroll down and look for the product names and look under build number short format and compare this number to what you wrote down earlier. Here we see 15.2.792.3 corresponds to Exchange Server 2019 Cumulative Update 8. Now write this down too, because we'll go to the download page for the updates. Go to the Exchange Team blog for the 2021 March security updates. Scroll down until you see your server version and minimum cumulative update required. If you do not see your server version listed, then click on the page for the older cumulative updates right here. Please note that if you apply the updates to an older cumulative update, that the security update is only temporary. You will still need to install the latest cumulative update and then reapply the security update for that cumulative update to bring the server fully up to date. This video does not cover installing cumulative updates. For this example, we see we had Exchange Server 2019 Cumulative Update 8. So we'll click here. And then scroll down to the bottom and look for the corresponding security update. Click that. Click download. And then save. Now open the folder and we can see the downloaded update here. You must install the update from an elevated command prompt. The process will stop the Exchange service during the install, and it will also require you to restart the server after the update, so plan accordingly. Click the Start menu and start typing command. And once you see the command prompt, right click and select Run as Administrator. If you're not already running as an administrator, it will prompt you for entering credentials. Switch to the downloads directory by typing cd for change directory and then downloads. And then type the dir command to list the contents of the directory. And you should see the update that was downloaded. Next, start typing exchange and then hit tab for autocomplete and then press enter. And this process will start the software to update. Now the update will take some time, so the video will skip to the end. The update has now finished. Click finish. It will then ask you to restart the server. Now that the security update is installed, you should determine if your server has already been compromised in order to remove any malware or web shells an attacker has dropped that will enable them to continue accessing it, even with the security update applied. See the next video in the series to determine if your server was compromised.